In my last video, I tested ND filters on the DJI Osmo Action 5 Pro to see how they perform in real-world conditions. I concluded that while ND filters are necessary to achieve truly cinematic motion blur in bright environments, they present a major challenge. Motion blur can significantly interfere with an action camera's electronic image stabilization, causing noticeable artifacts. This means you often have to choose between reducing stabilization effectiveness or compromising on the desired level of motion blur by breaking the 180-degree shutter rule. One interesting comment I received suggested an alternative approach, shooting in auto mode and adding motion blur in post. This idea has some clear advantages over using ND filters. For one, you don't have to deal with adjusting ND filters or dialing in specific shutter speeds. However, the viability of this approach would hinge on how comparable any motion blur added in post would be to true motion blur captured by shooting at a lower shutter speed. To test this alternative approach out, I pulled some footage I had shot with a high shutter speed where each frame was sharp and free from motion blur. I then applied DaVinci Resolve's built-in motion blur effect. First up was the classic hand-waving test. The effect clearly added motion blur. While individual frames looked a bit odd when frozen, the motion appeared fairly natural when played in real time. However, unlike genuine motion blur, this effect also caused a distortion in the areas surrounding the moving hand, which isn't ideal. Next, I tried the same test using some biking footage. Here's the original scene. And here's the same scene with motion blur added in post. When viewed side by side, the artificial motion blur is quite convincing, especially on the objects that pass by quickly. While the motion blur effect does make the footage appear smoother and doesn't necessarily look bad, I couldn't help but notice that it didn't quite replicate the look of real motion blur captured with a slower shutter speed. Here's some footage shot with the shutter speed manually set to 1/60th of a second. The most noticeable difference was the enhanced sense of speed, particularly in how the asphalt on the road blurred. The motion blur added in post couldn't accurately recreate this effect, making the ground appear relatively static in comparison. To see if there were more effective ways to add motion blur in post, I explored some advanced options that use more sophisticated motion analysis. One of these methods involves using a plugin called ReelSmart Motion Blur, while another utilizes a combination of optical flow and vector motion blur in DaVinci Resolve. Both techniques require significantly more processing power compared to the standard motion blur effect. For example, using the optical flow method in DaVinci Resolve took nearly an hour and a half to process just 4 minutes of footage on my laptop, which has an i9 processor and an RTX 4070 for reference. As you can see, it was hard to notice any significant improvement using these more advanced motion blur methods compared to the standard effect. In both cases, freezing frames revealed noticeable artifacts. Even when revisiting the hand-waving test, the standard motion blur effect actually seemed to produce a more natural result overall. So after these tests, I don't believe artificial motion blur can fully replace the real thing. However, it can still enhance existing footage, making it look slightly more natural and smooth. Perhaps in the future, more advanced AI-powered motion blur effects will become available. But for now, there's no simple solution to the motion blur and EIS problem without making some compromises.